Hello friends, welcome to MuckD, and in this video we'll be making a completely free website, and that too a dynamic one using a free hosting and domain account. I'm going to explain the step-by-step process, so stay tuned. So the first step here is to go to Google and search for Freenom. And you just go to freenom.com and enter whatever name you wish to register. Here I have entered MuckD, and here you get three options: GA, CF and GQ. I am going to select GA, and I recommend using GA because TK is not allowed on the free hosting account which I am using. So here you can select 12 months free hosting and click continue, and here you will get an invoice of $0. Now you just need to enter your email ID here on the left side, and I will be using one of my alternate email IDs, and you just click verify my email, and you will have to click through this verification process. This might take some time if you are a newbie to this. So once you click verify, you will get this verification link sent message, and what you have to do is you have to go to your Gmail account and click on the link which you get in your email. I will just show you here. So let's log into this account and just click the email you get from Freenom. It's titled Freenom email verification, and just click on this link, and you'll have to fill the details like first name, last name, address, zip code, city, country, state, etc. I think the mobile number can be left blank, I'm not sure. Let's try it out. No, you'll have to fill it up. So let's put in a number, and here you go. And this has created your free domain. So just click here to go to your client area on your domain account. And on the top you will get the services. Just click on my domains. And here click on my manage domains. And in the management tools above, you will get a link called name servers, and here you will see the Freenom name servers. You will have to change this to custom name servers, and then go to a site called infinityfree.net, and this is a free, site which provides free hosting. So you just sign up here. So this is one of the sites which provides free hosting. There are several of the websites. Just complete this image verification process, and I missed the full email ID. So let's sign in, and you will get another email from your hosting account. So let's verify that email too. Just refresh your email account, and here you can just confirm your email address. And once you confirm it, you will get this plus new account button here. Just click on that, and here you will have to just copy the name servers and paste it in your Freenom account here. So you'll have to paste it, copy and paste it one by one. The only change is in the first NS1, NS2, NS3 and so on. So if you find this video a bit fast, you can just slow it down using the YouTube's control on the bottom right corner. So once you have done that, you just need to enter your new domain name here, muckd.ga, and just click on check. And here you will get your account details, including your hosting account's password. Now keep the account password safe, because this is how you upload files later. whenever you want to create a static website. But today we'll be creating a dynamic website, which will be a WordPress-based CMS website. I will just show you the step-by-step process. First, just click here, create account. And here you will get two buttons, one for the control panel and another for the client area. I will show both of these regions. Once you click the control panel, let's go to the client area first. So this is your client area. Here you will find details about your hosting account. You will also see your username as well as your password for this hosting account. And on the right side, you will get FTP information about how to upload the files to the server. So this I will be discussing in one of my later videos. But for the purpose of this video, let's go to the control panel. And here you will find ˌsiːˌplʌsˌplʌs apps installer. So just click on that and you will find several applications here which you can install by a single click. So just click on WordPress and just delete this WP here and leave everything else as it is. And here for the site name, you can just mention whatever site name you want to give. I am mentioning Makri Demo. And for the site description, I will just mention free website. Just keep this unticked. And for the password here, you can give whatever password you want to give when you want to log into the backend of the WordPress website. So remember that password also. And here I advise you to click on limit login attempts and then just click install. So this will install WordPress in a moment. So here you will get the message that WordPress has been successfully installed, and you can just click on the home page now and you will see that you already have a website called makri.ga and you have a number in front. So we will be changing this shortly. So for example, when you click on this hello world post, you will get p is equal to 1. So instead of that, we will be using some SEO friendly URLs. So to do that, you just have to click here on the admin section URL, and that will bring you here at the back end of the WordPress website. Just go to settings, permalinks, and click on post name and save changes. So this will make the URL quite fancy. So for example, now if you go to homepage and click on hello world, you will notice that the URLs are SEO friendly. So this is how you can make changes to the permalinks. You can go to pages and you can already see that there is a page called sample page, but on the home page of your website you will not see this page because you will have to manually add to the menu of the WordPress. That's how WordPress works. You can refer any of the documentation regarding WordPress. Here you can go to appearance menus and just click on create new menu. That will bring this right side field called menu name. You just have to enter the menu name here. I will just put on main menu and click on create menu, and in the bottom side just tick the top menu checkbox. And on the left side, just click on sample page and add to menu. That will add this sample page to the top menu, and just click on save menu here on the bottom right. Now let's check on our home page here. Now you will notice that the page has been added to the top menu. Similarly, you can add additional pages, a number of pages. So that's why I called this a dynamic website, because it's interactive in nature. So let's add a new page here called about, and I will just type some random text here. And you just need to click publish to save this and go to menus and tick the about checkbox and click add to menu. That will add this menu here. Just click on save menu and let's go to the home page. And here you see that the page has been already added to our website. So you can also change the overall design by going to appearance themes, and here you will find the default three themes which are available in the WordPress by default. You can activate any one of these. For example, I'm activating this one. So let's go to the new design. So here you can see that the content of the website hasn't changed, but the design has changed. So it's that easy. It's even easier even after you have posted some content to the website. Now that's the specialty of content management system, and WordPress is one of those CMS. So this is one of the other themes which is available in the WordPress backend. Apart from these three available themes, there are several new themes which you can install from the backend. To do this, you just go to themes and click on add new, and you will find several themes here. You can even click on popular to get some popular themes. So once it's loaded, you can just scroll down and select any one of these themes. I will just install this business spa theme, and I have just activated it, and this is how it looks. So you can further customize these themes. It's a very vast topic to cover in this tutorial. For the time being, I have shown you how to create a website, a dynamic website, totally free of cost, including a domain name and a hosting account, and that too a dynamic website. So hope you like this series on how to create a dynamic website in under 10 minutes. Do subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already, and please click the bell icon so that you get all the channel updates. So stay tuned and see you in the next video.